Well, again, a very good morning to you all, my dear students. Now, today, what we are going to study? We are going to study about the past tense. What we have completed? We have completed the present tense, all the four parts of the present tense. Those four parts are simple, continuous, perfect, and perfect continuous. We have done exercises as well as we have learned the formulas. I hope that you have learned all the formulas so that we can proceed. So let's talk about past tense. What is past tense? Very general definition. Past is something which is over, which is finished before the present time. What is present time? Which is going on right now. The current time is called present time, whereas which is over or finished before this time is called the past time or past tense in English. So as you know, it has also four parts, that is simple, continuous, perfect and perfect continuous. So we have these four parts of past tense and we are going to study the very first one, that is the simple part of it. So before starting or before telling you the uses, let me write formulas for you. Structure for simple or affirmative sentences is subject plus verb second form plus object. So if I write Ram, go second form is went to school. And for your, do you understand? Let me write Ram goes to school. So here I have two sentences. Subject is same, both are Ram. Even the predicate or the object is same, to school. What changes here is the verb form. If you see this, go is the first form. And when I talk about first form, I got to know that the scenario is talking about the present situation. Whereas when I see went, that is the second form, I easily got to know that the scenario belongs to the past time. It means that right now in the present scenario, whether Ram is going to school or not, I am not aware of it. But yes, this sentence states that Ram went to school in the past time. Ram has gone to school. Now, the negative one. So past simple tense negative formula is subject plus helping verb, that is did, plus not plus verb first form plus object. What it becomes? Ram did not go to school. If you notice in the present tense, in the present simple tense, it is do or does. But here it is did. Why? Because the second form of the do is did. Now, let's talk about the third formula, which is interrogative. Interrogative becomes helping verb plus did plus subject plus verb first form plus object. What it becomes? Did Ram go to school? At the place of helping verb did, I put did. Subject is Ram. Verb first form is go. To is the proposition to link up the verb as well as the object, and object is school. Three more formulas we have here. Let me write these formulas for you. So the next one comes is interrogative negative. Interrogative negative is helping verb, that is did, plus subject plus not plus verb first form plus object. What it becomes? Did Ram not go to school? Now WH interrogative is WH word plus did, which is helping verb of course, plus subject plus verb first form plus object. What it becomes? WH word as it is, why, did, subject as in Ram, go to school. Why did Ram go to school? Last one is WH word plus interrogative negative. So what it becomes is WH word plus helping verb, that is did, plus subject plus not plus verb first form plus object. What it becomes? Why did Ram not go to school? So this is about all the formulas which we will be needing, which we will need to solve the simple past tense. Apart from these formulas, now let's talk about the uses. Uses are very important, as I tell you in every of my class. So let's talk about, let's begin with the uses of it. Uses of simple past tense. For example, the very first one is when the activity has taken place in past and the time is mentioned or implied. When I'm saying this, what I mean with it is that when the time is mentioned, means maybe I have not, maybe that I didn't sleep well last night. So let's take an example. I didn't, or simply you can say that did not. This is the contracted form, this is the normal form. I didn't sleep well last night. When I am saying it, I got to know last night. So last night of course means it is just the previous night of the morning, of today's morning. Just the previous night is called the last night. I am not talking about three nights before or four nights before, but last night means the time is mentioned. Or let me give you one more example. Gandhiji gave a discourse on prayer many years ago. If you see many years ago, it is again, it is the time which is mentioned, ago, many years ago. It means I am talking about the past and the time is mentioned here. Now let me tell you one more example for you today. That is, the swan queen did not let her son orphan. So here I can see that did is there, did not is there, but the time is not mentioned. Time is implied. What I mean by mentioned and implied, mentioned is something which is given, that at what time, many years ago, 2 years ago, last night, yesterday, these are the times which are mentioned of the
past tense. But when I say implied, implied means that I got to know by myself, thus yes, the activity has taken place in the past. One more example, if I write, I went to school. So I'm using I went to school. Went means, now here I am not describing any time. Of course, it means that I went. I go to school somewhere in the past. Now let's talk about our second use of simple past tense. The second use for simple past tense in improbable past conditions. What I mean by improbable? Probable means which is more likely to happen. Improbable means which is less likely to happen. Or probable means more of the possibility. Improbable means less of the possibility. For example, if I write, if you worked hard, you would pass. So there is improbable past condition. What is that improbable past condition? That if you worked hard, that is, he has not done work hard, that is the reason he has not passed. You is the subject, work, second form is work, hard is the adjective here. You would pass. But improbability is there that the chances of happening is very less, the possibility is very less. So it is improbable condition that if you worked hard, you would have passed. Now let's talk about point number 3 of ours, which is use of was or were to denote a state. Use of was or were to denote a state. When I am saying that use of was or were to denote a state, what does it mean is he was asleep. When I am saying he was asleep, so definitely it means that somewhere in the past time he was sleeping. It is a state. In which state he was? He was in the state of sleeping. He was asleep. Last one is, fourth one and the last one, use of present simple tenses, sorry, past simple tenses. The last use is that to describe the past habits using used to. For example, if I write, I then used to swim. So when I am using used to word, it means I am talking some of my past habit in the past, not present. I like to swim or I am habitual of swimming, but somewhere in the past I then means at that particular time I then used to swim. So this is what all for the class of the day. What we have learned, we have learned the simple past tense formulas, 16 numbers. I have written it for you, kindly write it in your notebook and learn it. Second is the 4 uses of simple past tense. This is also you have to learn, because tomorrow when I will come up again, I will come up with the exercise, and to solve the exercise, now you know very well, you must remember all the formulas as well as the uses. That is all for the class today. Tomorrow I will again come. Till the time, have a good day ahead.